Excuse me. What is up, guys? Dashing here for episode 136 of Community Universe Mode. Live here on Monday Night Raw, just 3 weeks away from Over the Limit. Kicking things off here tonight with hashtag trending worldwide, taking on Hillbilly Blue Blood, as they are calling themselves now, Rex Carter and Xander Slate. Of course, a rematch from last week in which Slate introduced Carter as his tag team partner. And they actually got one up over Chet Taylor and Shinaz Anadoni, defeating the duo. After the match is over, Shinaz Anadoni and Chet Taylor got into a heated argument, which saw Shinaz leave Chet Taylor in the ring. So hopefully whatever that was between the two, that little spat, is done and over with, so they can focus on their tag team title defense in 3 weeks' time at Over the Limit. Rex Carter and Xander Slate already with a ton of momentum now heading into that title match. Obviously got the upper hand, but hashtag trending worldwide can turn the tides right here, right now, tonight. Hello, Borton. Hello, Chrissy. My Twitter feed's awful. Well, I don't post anything on Twitter. I just, I'm pretty sure all my Twitter feed is the videos I've liked on YouTube. So please chill. Hello, Maury. Hello, Kinzel. Hello, Voodoo. Kinzel finally unbanned for being the little miscreant that he is on the fucking Twitch chats. Rest in peace, Kinzel 2015.
The following tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. On the way to the ring, the WWE Tag Team Champions, Chet Taylor and Shantoni.
Chet Taylor and Shinaz Anadoni have hashtag trending worldwide. They're looking like they're on the same page. Came out here, shook hands. Tag team titles are on their waist. Longest reigning tag team champions of all time here in CMB. They will be defending those belts against Rex Carter and Xander Slate, a.k.a. Hillbilly Blue Blood, at the Over the Limit pay-per-view, the last pit stop before the third annual WrestleMania and the Season 2 finale. So 2K16 comes our way, just 3 weeks. Hashtag pumped. A lot of action here tonight, though, on Monday Night Raw. Main event tonight, gonna see the World Heavyweight Champion, Justin Zane. Wait a minute, what? Oh, I got confused there for a second. I thought Rex Carter already entered. Jesus, Dashing, wake up. Our main event tonight, though, as I was saying, the World Heavyweight Champion, Justin Zane, gonna team with Troy Voodoo to take on Levi Marta and Hayden. We learned earlier this week that Levi Marta will go one-on-one with Justin Zane at Over the Limit in a non-title match. But if Levi Marta is able to defeat Justin Zane, then the main event, the third annual WrestleMania, will be turned into a triple threat. Justin Zane will have to defend against both Levi Marta and the 2017 Royal Rumble winner, of course, Hayden Blade Keitley. A couple matches confirmed actually this week for the Over the Limit pay-per-view. We've also got Troy Voodoo going to challenge Jackson Jordan for the United States Championship. Of course, last week, remember, it was supposed to be Jordan versus Cage, which we will see tonight. It was supposed to take place last week, though, but thanks to Voodoo's interference attacking Cage, then taking his place in the match, Voodoo actually got one up over Jordan, becoming only the second man in CMB history to defeat Jackson Jordan, defeated by pinfall or submission. It looks like Slate's got a new entrance here. A new theme song, ditching the Corey Graves theme song. Rest in peace. Got to get ready for 2K16. Corey Graves and the 2K16, guys. But Jackson Jordan laying his United States Championship on the line in order to get his hands on Troy Voodoo. Troy Voodoo said he wouldn't accept the rematch unless Jordan put the United States title on the line. So Jordan's done that. The match will take place in 3 weeks' time. Of course, the gauntlet match for a shot at the Hardcore Championship come the second annual WrestleMania will be taking place at Over the Limit. So far, we've got Randy Orton, Kendall Wolf, Paul Devine, and Zach Payne announced. A couple more still to be revealed though over the coming weeks. And Tim LaFave will be defending his Hardcore Championship at Over the Limit as well. Against two, we do not know. He'll be taking on Omega Z later on tonight, though. And look at this now. The tag team champions arguing as to who's going to start this match off. And it looks like Chet Taylor wants to kick things off here against Rex Carter. Yet again, we see some tension between the tag champs. It's not good. Rex Carter and Xander Slick look to capitalize on that, as they did last week. Hello, Twisted. Good to see you here. Chet Taylor with a double boot stomp, and now he's going to tag in Shinaz and Andone. What was the point of that argument then? If Chet Taylor's just going to tag Shinaz in like 30 seconds later, whatever. Maybe they got over it already. They realize that they cannot put their title reign in jeopardy. They have to work together. They have to be on the same page as Carter now. Just going to stomp on the ribs of Shinaz. The hillbilly back to his feet. Beautiful wheel kick there by the big man. Quite the combo in a backstage interview with Xander Slate and Rex Carter. Xander Slate said, hey, you ever hear that saying, opposites attract, you know, attract. Rex Carter, you know, he lives in a trailer park, he drinks too much beer, he smells of biscuits and gravy, and got me over here. I grew up in a, you know, rich town, I like to sip fine wines. But we get the job done together, and he said, as long as we stick side by side, there's nothing we can't accomplish in this company. I mean, they already have a victory in their first night together as a tag team. They defeated the tag champs last week. Shinaz actually requesting this rematch here tonight. Really demanding it. Of course, Xander Slate allowing Rex Carter to say their tag team name, Hillbilly Blue Blood. It's actually, that's the name, Hillbilly Blue Blood. You gotta put the laugh there. Rex Carter is Festus repackaged, confirmed. GG. Look at Shinaz with these reverse atomic drops on Xander Slate now. It's a fashion statement, Prizzy. Please chill. And now Chet Taylor asking for the tag. It's the Punjabi Playboy, a.k.a. the real number one Bubba, a.k.a. Johnny Gat. Shinaz Andone here. Taking it to Xander Slate. Slate can retaliate with a nice Samoan drop fall-away slam. Going to follow that up with a rolling senton. Shinaz... looks like Shinaz about to run over to Rex Carter. Forgot who his tag team partner was there for a second. And now an exploder suplex by the former two-time World Heavyweight Champion. Xander Slate placed in third of the Cyborg Invitation. Or fourth, I should say. That's how he earned the tag team title shot that he and Rex Carter will get 3 weeks' time and Over the Limit. Got that briefcase. American Justice, of course, going to be U.S. title shot, Duo Maxwell fired. Rest in peace, God of Death. We'll miss you. Now, Shinaz just clotheslined Hulk Hogan. You just can't see him. And what is this now? Glam Slam by Xander Slate. I haven't seen him hit that before. That's his OG finisher from back in the Indies. Uh-oh, wait a minute. Slate walks Slam in down now. I keep botching Slate's finish. Finisher names these past couple of weeks. Slate walk slam, I should say. Gonna go for the pin, only a one count though. And now Slate immediately gonna go for his finisher, misses somehow as Chet Taylor has his force field activated, I guess. He's gonna get it on the second attempt though. Oh, goes for the submission. This is what defeated Chet Taylor last week. Taylor tapped out to this, but Slate lets go for some reason. Was that a rope break? I don't think so. Slate let go pretty early there. Now Slate going to tie up Taylor's legs, going for a cloverleaf pain here. And Chet Taylor is just getting dominated right now at the hands of Xander Slate, ladies and gentlemen. He's got to try to tag in Shinaz Andone here. Try to mount a comeback or something. Can't keep this up, or he and Shinaz will suffer yet another loss to Xander Slate and Rex Carter. Look at that. Chet Taylor just outrunning Slate right there. What is it called? Juking him? To get the tag of Shinaz, and Xander tags in Rex Carter. The hillbilly and the real number one Bubba now gonna go at it. And immediately Carter with a huge waist side slam. covers for the pin. One, only a one count. I think it's considered a reverse STO, Tim. It's definitely not a jumping complete shot. Jumping complete shot, you jump. Obviously. I'm pretty sure it's a variation of a reverse STO. It is a reverse STO. You literally just lift him up before you hit it. So GG. You see that gameplay video between Goldust and Stardust? They have so many beautiful new STO or reverse STO animations. It's making me a little bit hard. Wait a minute, Shanaz, what's he going for here? Going for that half Nelson neckbreaker like he used. Covers for the pin. That'll be a rope break, though, for the hillbilly. And Chet Taylor's going to do some quick squats here. Got to keep himself limber. Another wheel kick by the big guy. And some more squats by Chet Taylor. It's four squats right there. Tag in to Xander Slate now. No, Chrissy, you don't know the difference between that. Oh, what is this? Some reverse STO. Reverse STOs. Think of reverse STOs now. Reverse atomic drops. Oh, look at this. Shanaz stalking Xander Slate for his finisher. That's right in the corner of the Hillbilly Blue Blood, though. Or not the Hillbilly Blue Blood. Gonna go for the pin nonetheless. I think that'll be a rope break. It is. Shanaz Andoni. Not the smartest place to be hitting your finisher. Counter by Slate, though. Put Shanaz in the corner. Counter by Shanaz. Put Slate in the corner. Gonna try to tag in Chet here. No, puts him up on the top rope. And the referee telling him to get down from there. Shanaz is setting Slate up for... What is this? A superplex. Shanaz Andoni showing off his strength here. Gonna cover for the pin? No, he goes for a break of the eye. Jesus. He has a weapon there. Not very nice. The dirty heel. Shanaz Andoni. This is our first matchup of the evening. Non-title match between hashtag trending worldwide and Hillbilly Blue Blood. Rematch from last week. Match again will take place in 3 weeks at Over the Limit. Titles will be on the line then, though, rolling senton by Slate. And now Shanaz looking for his comeback. Slate going to try to shut that down, though. Botches the dropkick to the knee. Or maybe Shanaz botched it. Shanaz never botches, though. It was Slate's fault, obviously. A running reverse atomic drop. Shanaz still have that comeback. Yes, he does. He was just out of the ring for a minute there. That was weird. One forearm. Can we get a second? Yes, we can. Duck Slate's clothesline attempt. And there's a wicked spine brush. Let's get that pelvic thrust. There it is. Slate, smart, though, to crawl to his corner. Maybe not. Rex Carter, forgetting he's in a match, jumps off the ring apron. GG. Hello, Dynamic. Now Slate looking for his comeback. Shanaz should hit that signature right there, but Slate had force fields activated. Slate has his comeback, though. Rake the eyes by Shanaz Andoni and reverse STO by Andoni. Now got to cover for the pin. One, two. Rex Carter going to save the day there. Carter thinking that Xander Slate might have been in a spot of trouble right there. Wait a minute. Shanaz has another finisher. A boot to the side of the head. A second one for Xander Slate. Hello, Zach, too. I didn't see the first one. Shanaz not able to capitalize, though, as Slate's going to take advantage of that hot tag. And here comes the hillbilly. Rex Carter on fire. Takes down Shanaz. Knocks the true hipster of CFB off the ring apron. Can he capitalize? No, Shanaz counters, luckily. And look at that. Andoni fired up right now. Spears Xander Slate off the ring apron, allowing Carter to capitalize. Or maybe not. Shanaz counters the counter. Rex Carter counters the counter of the counter, though. Now putting him in the corner. What is Carter looking for here? Ooh, some wicked elbows right to the temple. That could be it, guys. Rex covering for the pin. One, two. Only a two count, though. Just barely as Taylor breaks up the pin. And Xander, not the legal man, just comes in and stomps on Andoni's knee, it looks like. Good guy, Xander. Helping out his tag team partner. That's going to allow Rex Carter to hit that nasty big boot. And that could be lights out for Shanaz, guys. One, two, the good guy referee waiting for Chet Taylor to get to the ring before he starts counting, though. Bless your heart, referee. Bless your heart. Carter now the finisher in his pocket and immediately goes for the Rexplex. Carter ain't playing around here. Oh, he almost threw him out of the ring. That's all the way across the ring, guys. Oh, Carter, just pin him, you Daft Brick. One, two. Oh, Taylor just makes it there. Now Xander Slate climbing to the second turnbuckle. Oh, attacking Shanaz. The referee's paying attention to Taylor. He didn't see it. Starting to count Taylor out. Rex Carter not only get the job done, but go for the pin here yet again. That's going to be a rope breaker. Just barely, but the ref with a good call. And Shanaz now trying to eliminate Carter from the Royal Rumble. That was 2 weeks ago, Shanaz. Please chill. And what a hook there by Rex Carter, looking to tag in Slate now. Great teamwork by Hillbilly Blue Blood, but Shanaz trying to crawl his way over to Taylor, looking for that hot tag. Can he get there? Yes, he can, just in time. And here comes Chet Taylor now. He's been out of action for a while, nice and fresh. Takes out Slate, knocks Carter off the ring apron. And what's this? Uh-oh. The dreaded suplex DDT. That could be it, guys, if Taylor can make the pin. Flips Slate over. Covers, but Rex Carter able to recuperate. But no! Shanaz stops him. Luckily, Slate kicks out on his own. That could have been it right there, guys. Rex Carter got in the ring, but then just stood there. Shanaz punching him in the face. Chet Taylor is the legal man now. Looking to hit the vintage gut check. Double knees right to the ribs. That's got to be it. Slate's taking a lot of damage here. Dragging away from the ropes, making sure there's no rope break. Covers for the pin. One, only a one count though. Carter breaking it up. Slate with a Lutez press, follows it up with a couple punches right to the jaw. Carter asking for the tag, realizes his partner here might be in trouble. Xander covers though. Break up by Shanaz at one. Oh, Slate, is that a finisher? Yes, he does. Going for the Slate by Slate. That Shanaz should be able to break that up pretty easily, though. Only a one count for Xander Slate there. Over the Limit is the next pay-per-view, Maury. Not WrestleMania. WrestleMania is the pay-per-view after Over the Limit, the Season 2 finale, before we head on over to 2K16, tag in a Rex Carter now. And Chet Taylor might have been looking for winning the internet victory roll, though, and Slate's out, guys. One, two. No! Oh, Carter counters. Shanaz breaks it up, though. Get out of there, Tony. Ref, count him out. Come on, what is this? Uh-oh, Chet Taylor going for gentrification here on the big guy. Oh, he's struggling, trying to lift him up, but he gets him. Double underhook driver, and that's got to be it. Chet Taylor going to hook the leg. Referee's taking his time, getting in position, though, allowing Slick to break up the pin. Very back and forth tag team match between these four men. Last week it was really like kind of domination by Hillbilly Blue Blood. Of course they picked up the win in that encounter, but now it's here tonight, episode 136. Both teams really giving it their all. Shanaz and Oney and Chet Taylor feel they need this win to tie it up. Have the rubber match over the limit. They can't take another loss. A clean loss nonetheless to their number one contenders. And Slate trying to help out Rex, but he misses. Oh, and a big boot out of thin air. One, two. Oh, Shanaz literally just in time. The Carter didn't even start running there. He just hit the big boot from a standing position. And Chet goes for his comeback. Carter ain't having that, though. Carter going to go for another standing finisher? No, what's he doing here? Countered by Chet Taylor. Now gonna flip him over, having some trouble there. Rex Carter, a big guy. And Taylor, Chet Taylor, he's gonna finish her maybe? No, he's going for Slate. How's he going for Slate? Oh, you realize that Xander's not the legal man. Please chill. Uh-oh. Another vintage gut check, guys. That's way on the other side of the ring. I don't know if Slate will be able to make it there in time. Oh, Chet Taylor not gonna be able to make it to the pin, though. As Shanaz does some quick squats here. Flips him over, covers for the pin. One, two, Xander gets by Shanaz though to break it up. Looks like it's gonna be a three count there. Chet Taylor looking for his finisher there, winning the internet, that single leg high knee. Rex Carter has a finisher too, remember though. Some forearms to the back here. Rex Carter's caught in between the ropes. Going to finish it off, that double knee backbreaker. Uh-oh, Chet Taylor looking for another gentrification. The second time Rex Carter's being hit with this. Chattel lift him up overhead, gonna drive him neck first right into the mat with the referee. Apparently there was a shockwave off of that. One, two, three, and Chet Taylor gets the victory. Xander Slate taking his time, getting over to break up the pin, and Chet Taylor gets the victory over Rex Carter with a second gentrification, making the score even. Hillbilly Blue Bloods have a win, and now hashtag trending worldwide have a win, making their match at Over the Limit a rubber match, and that will be for the tag team titles, folks. Taylor and Shanash really needed this victory, though. They could not have let Xander Slate and Carter get another win over them. Come on, Carter. Jesus Christ. My cat, Carter, not Rex Carter. Somehow he opens up my door and it's fully closed. Freaking OP cat here. Tag team champions with a great victory here tonight over their number one contenders. Hopefully they're putting whatever's going on between these arguments they've been having. Last week, Shanaz stormed out of the ring, started this matchup. They argued as to who was going to start things off against Rex Carter, but maybe this victory will put whatever beef they got aside. Great victory for Chet Taylor and Shanaz Andone. Got that rubber match now, and it will be for the championships. Championship. 3 weeks time at Over the Limit. I hate this cat so much. I hate this cat more than life, I swear. But now that matchup we were meant to see last week, the United States champion Jackson Jordan going to take on Zach Cage, his tag team partner Ryan Kent ringside. Not only supporting his friend and partner here, but also on the lookout for Troy Voodoo, making sure the number one contender for the U.S. title doesn't try to interfere again. Attack either Jordan or Cage. Remember, Troy Voodoo seemingly, apparently attacked Cage backstage, tossed him out on the ramp, and then took his place against Jordan last week, actually picking up the victory. Jordan actually laying his title on the line Over the Limit just to get another shot, try to get some revenge against Voodoo. Voodoo said he wouldn't step in the ring with Jackson Jordan again unless he put that title on the line. Jackson letting his anger get the better of him. He might regret that. Got to calm down. Only been beaten twice in his career, his 6 months career. 6 month career, not 6 months. Beaten by Justin Sane a couple months ago, beaten by Voodoo last week. Jackson Jordan, the United States champion now for 2 months. Almost 3 months at Over the Limit. Beating the likes of Jake Watson, Shanaz Andone, Chet Taylor. American Justice just a couple weeks ago at the Royal Rumble. Defeated American Justice pretty easily nonetheless. Not something a whole lot of people can say. Zach Cage and Ryan Kent taking a loss to X-Gen last week on main event thanks to a pre-match assault by Troy Voodoo and Justin Sane attacking Kent while Troy Voodoo went after Zach Cage. I don't know what Voodoo has against Cage. Maybe just trying to make an example out of him. We all know the history between Kent and Sane, though. That died a couple months ago, though. Justin Sane attacked 4 people last week. He attacked Hayden. Four people. He attacked Hayden. Then didn't he attack someone else on Raw? Who else did he attack on Raw? He attacked Hayden on Raw. I know he attacked Zach Penn and Ryan Kent on Raw, or on main event, I should say. I'm pretty sure he attacked someone on Raw, didn't he? Who did he attack? I don't remember. Maybe it's just three people. But he was on kind of a spree last week, bashing Zach Penn in the face with his World Heavyweight Championship after he beat Voodoo. Troy Voodoo and Justin Zane, apparently, I don't know, friends now, maybe? Maybe Justin Zane really is getting recruited to join X-Gen. Everybody would die if that happened. Especially poor old Kinsel Carter. Oh my god, I hate this cat, dude. I swear. Here we go, one-on-one, Jackson Jordan and Zach Cage, the match that was meant to take place last week. Last week was supposed to be a Falls Count Anywhere match. This is just a standard singles match, though. Non-title, of course. Huge opportunity for Cage, though, as his partner and friend Kent watches ringside. Side headlock by Cage. Takes Jackson down to the canvas. Jackson gonna counter, though, with a head scissors. Zach Cage having to bring Ryan Kent out here for security, for backup, just in case Voodoo or Justin Zane try to show their face again. Poor Zach Cage, man. He really is. Someone said it last week that Zach Cage is like the Heath Slater of our universe. Every time he comes out for a match, he just gets attacked by someone else. They take his place. Rest in peace, Zach Cage. Nice flipping kick there. I don't know what exactly what it's called. The flipping kick by Zach Cage. Kind of botched it, though. Or maybe Jackson botched it. One of them botched it. Didn't look too great. A lot of action to get to tonight. Up next, we're going to see Randy Borton and Paul Devine go at it. Two of the men announced for the gauntlet match at Over the Limit for a shot to take on the Hardcore Champion at the third annual WrestleMania alongside Zach Penn and Kendall Wolf. Still a couple more to be announced. Gauntlet match, of course, if you don't know how it works. Two men will start in the ring. Once one man is eliminated, another man will come out. And that keeps on going until every single man is entered. Last man standing in the ring will be the number one contender for the Hardcore title. Get eliminated by pinfall or submission or count out disqualification. When has that ever happened, though? CMV. Everybody in CMV follows the rules. They're good people. They're all faces inside. Nice float over DDT there. And now Jordan dragging Cage in the middle of the ring. Size him up for a dropkick to the side of the head. Maybe if Zach Cage can get a victory over Jackson Jordan here tonight, he'll be entered into the gauntlet match. Of course, it's for Jackson Jordan's the United States champion, but still a victory over any champion. Definitely going to improve your odds of a title shot. That springboard senton kind of botched it a little bit. This match has a couple botches in it already. This is our botched match of the night, ladies and gentlemen. Ooh, look at that. Cage going for a punt. Jackson catches him with the backslide driver, though. And I think he was setting up for the finisher already. Not even going to bother going for the pin. Cage looking for his comeback, though. What a hurricane rana. Covers for the pin. That should be a rope break, though, or maybe not. Jackson Jordan pay off the ref, or that was a weird angle. Maybe his foot wasn't on the bottom rope. Wait a minute, going for the hashtag. Cage counters, though. Doesn't want to get hit with that fist. You see what it does to everybody else. Nice reverse DDT there by the United States champion. Now going to cover for the pin. One, two, three. Oh, he got it. Jackson Jordan pinning Zach Cage off the reverse DDT. Hashtag confirms Zach Cage is Heath Slater. Damn. And here's some highlights from Zach Cage reversed the hashtag too, just to be pinned by reverse DDT a few moments later. Poor Cage, man. I guess he took a lot of damage off that backslide driver, and now what's going on? Jackson Jordan leaving the ring. It's Troy Voodoo! Voodoo gonna attack Cage again? Come on, Voodoo. This is too much. Wait a minute. Jackson Jordan. Jackson Jordan not going to let it happen. Hammering away at Troy Voodoo. Pushing him into the ropes. Clotheslining Voodoo over the top ropes. Telling Voodoo to get the hell out of here. And Cage gets back to his feet to see that Jackson has saved him. Jackson Jordan with that face turn, ladies and gentlemen. Saving Zach Cage from another beatdown at the hands of Troy Voodoo. Jackson Jordan saying, no way, no how. You're not going to attack Zach Cage. had enough. What's Troy Voodoo have against Zach Cage, though, for real? I'm like, what? I don't even think they've ever talked before, but Troy Voodoo just has it out for Cage, man. We will see Jackson Jordan defend his U.S. title against Troy Voodoo in 3 weeks' time and Over the Limit. So Jackson Jordan getting a little bit of upper hand over Troy Voodoo here tonight. And Kent just left. Yeah, Kent was out there for protection in case Voodoo came out. But then he just left after the match was over. He was like, all right, I'm out of here. So Jackson Jordan had to step in. And indeed, Randy Bourne is in action up next against Paul Devine. Omega Z joining him. We will see Omega Z in action later on tonight. He'll be taking on the hardcore champion, Tim LaFave. Up next after this, we'll see Cole Savage take on Ringo Max. Cole Savage, Ringo Max, and Christian having their problems with Markantel and Ringo Max as of late. Our main event to come here tonight, episode 136, Community Universe Mode, 3 weeks away from Over the Limit. Justin Sane and Troy Voodoo team up, take on Levi Marta and Hayden. Here comes the King of Main Event. The Prince of Main Event, I should say. The Prince of Main Event, the King with the Bronze, the Man with the Bronze Shovel. The King with the Bronze Shovel, GG Dashing. The King of the Bronze Shovels, Randy Orton. Randy Orton's taking a loss to Paul Anderson last week on Main Event. Great matchup between those two. Orton, again, is one of the men announced for the Gauntlet match at Over the Limit alongside Paul Devine, Zach Payne, and Kendall Wolf. The winner will get their chance to fight for the hardcore title at the third annual WrestleMania. Big names in there already. Zach Payne, a former hardcore champion in his own right. Paul Devine, the man who keeps chasing that hardcore title this entire past year. Randy Orton, also a former hardcore champion. Like Randy Orton if he was black instead of white? What? Why does he have to be black for you to like him? Come on, Voodoo, you dirty racist. Confirmed, Voodoo is racist towards white people. Here come X-Gen at the first time. We'll see them tonight. Again, Omega Z will take on Tim LaFave in a non-title match. Later on in the show, and Troy Voodoo of X-Gen. Troy Voodoo is a member of X-Gen, remember. Don't forget. He'll be in the main event alongside Justin Sane taking on Levi Martin and Hayden. I swear to God, once the stream is over, I'm going to chuck this cat out the goddamn window. I'm not even joking either. God, I hate cats more than life itself. My sister's stupid fucking cat, dude. His name's Carter, too. Rex Carter, I named him. That's what I call him. Rex Carter, the hillbilly cat. Rest in peace. Here we go. Randy Orton, Paul Devine, Juan a Juan, mano y mano. A little to get some momentum heading into Over the Limit. Randy Orton doesn't have the greatest track record against X-Gen in the past. Omega Z, Duo Maxwell. I don't think him and Paul Devine have ever fought. Maybe he and Sushi X. I don't know about Devine, though. Pretty sure every time Orton has stepped in the ring with a member of the X-Gen stable, he's lost. Well, he did beat Duo Maxwell in the Cyborg Invitational, though. That was thanks to a free match attack by Caden Kenner, so it was pretty heel. It was a pretty dirty maneuver by the face of the year, Randy Orton. Please chill, Tim. There's like five Canadians on the Raw roster. There's Randy Orton, Jake Watson, Zach Payne, Tyson Kidd. Pretty sure there's someone else with it. Zach Payne, Jake Watson, Randy Orton, Tyson Kidd. Someone else is Canadian too. I don't remember though. Hurricane Rana by Paul Devine now. Takes Randy Orton off his feet. Borton going to try to retaliate with a drop kick. Paul Devine about that life, though. Throws the legs aside. What's that? Oh, it's like a bullplex, right? That's called, I'm pretty sure. Never seen Devine hit that before. The strength of Paul Devine is incredible. Pullback attack. Will it pay off? No, kick to the midsection. How many Canadians are supposed to be on the roster? The entire roster is going to be Canadians in case this team confirmed. Oh, yeah, Christian's from Canada. I don't know about Victor, though. He's got him up. High angle dick grab by Randy Borton. Randy Borton on a quest to feel everybody's dick on the Raw roster. Tilt-a-Whirl small package. Doesn't hook it in for the pin, though, making that move pretty useless. Borton finally firing back some offense. Nice European uppercut. Both men back to their feet. Another beautiful dropkick by Devine. Executed to perfection. Comeback attack. Jawbreaker, though, by Randy Borton. Rest in peace, Blizzard. Omega Z does have a beautiful attire. A single arm back body drop now by the Asian sensation. Oh, what a lion salt to follow it up. Nice combo there. Doesn't get him for the pin, though. Paul Devine knows Randy Borton's pretty resilient. Gonna take more than just a lion salt to keep him down. And now Randy Borton looking to make Devine humble. Locking in a camel clutch. That'll be a rope break, though. Ref forcing the break.
Big time shot delivered to Youngblood.
Mega Z likes what he's seeing right now. Paul Devine firmly in control. Lift up power bomb now, but Borton counters. Some punches to the top of the head there. Gonna follow that up with a T-bone suplex. Double boot stomp by the king of main event, the man with the golden shovel, aka the prince of main event, and the man with the bronze shovel, Randy Borton. What has happened to you? I gotta start booking Borton against the newbies again so he can get some wins. Paul Devine counters that punch. Nice spinning back elbow. Very slow pace between these two. Didn't really expect that high angle dick grab yet again. Borton with the signature first. That's pretty surprising. Paul Devine's been dominating Borton. Borton's only gotten a few moves in. That momentum, though, please chill. Gets the fall-away slam, though. Only a two count. Borton looking to finish things off. Going to stalk Devine for the super kick, but Devine gets up before Borton can back up. Devine doesn't want to get hit with that super kick or the Borto N. Hurricane Rana yet again by the Asian sensation. Now just stomping on his dick. Lion Salt, number two in the match. This time he hooks the leg for the pin. One, only a one count, though. I did not make these calls. I made one call, my call, Xander Slate, but all the other calls are made by the people in the chat. Community Universe mode. People's calls played in Universe. Wait a minute. Oh, the Borto N as Paul Devine was going for his signature. Gets caught with the Borto N, and will that be it? No! Paul Devine kicks out the very last millisecond. Devine just ain't about that right there. He's about to go for his signature. Borton's like, nope. That's what I was going to say, because Devine's really not taking a whole lot of damage in hands of Borton. I don't know how Borton got a signature that quick. Paul Devine, though, looking for his signature. He's trying to hit before. Gonna flip Borton around for the Mugen flip. Planting the King of Main Event right down on the top of his dome. Cover now. One, two, only a two count. And now, Paul Devine looking to finish things off here. Kicks Borton in the gut. Go for Devine intervention. Love your rope breaks out. No, Borton's nowhere near the rope. In fact, Devine's legs under the bottom rope. Oh, but Borton kicks out somehow. Borton manages to kick out of Devine intervention. What a matchup between these two. Now Paul Devine looking for his comeback. Borton going to try to shut him down. Gets countered into a Russian leg sweep, however. Leg sweep. Elbow to the back of the head by Borton, trying to fight back Paul Devine. Devine still has his comeback. Gets countered into a schoolboy, though. That'll be a rope break. Don't know how the ref saw that, but he did somehow. And Borton with these Texas jabs backing Devine into the corner. Devine flipping Borton around, having them. You can flip? No. Goes for a regular maneuver. Countered, though, by Randy. Borton with a back body drop sends Paul Devine out of the ring, eliminated from the Royal Rumble. These Texas jabs by Borton, dude. Borton's not even from Texas. What the hell? sit out Spinebuster on the outside of the ring and inflict some extra damage there. And he's forced back in the ring. Counter by Devine, puts Borton underneath the bottom rope, elbow right to the throat, gonna follow that up with a leg drop. Great back and forth matchup between these two. Now Devine was really dominating the first part of this contest. Springboard elbow, kind of hit him the wrong way, but whatever. And gonna turn just that right into a lion tamer, guys. Think Borton might tap here. Oh my God, Devine's got the knee dug right in the neck, wrenching back, and Borton's got a tap. No, he doesn't. Randy Borton sticking in there, refuses to tap to the lion tamer. I think Borton has another signature. Now Randy Borton gonna go for his snap DDT from a kneeling position, driving Devine face first into the mat. That's gotta be it. What a contest between these two here on Monday Night Raw. And Randy Borton gonna drag Devine away from the ropes. Doesn't want that rope break. One, two, only a two count though. That might have cost him dragging Devine away from Devine away from the ropes with Borton. Now looking for another Borton toe end perhaps. No, dragging Devine away from the ropes yet again. Double boot stomp. Just to try to wear down Paul just a little bit more before he hits his finisher. Springboard, body splash, botches it. Oh no, Devine rolls out of the way somehow. Oh, the super kick out of thin air. It just falls into the cover. One, two, three, and Randy Borton with a great victory. Jesus, man, that super kick came out of nowhere, shutting the lights out for Devine, then Borton literally passes out into the cover to get the three count, and what a matchup, what a victory for the king of main event, the king of Monday Night Raw, it seems. Yeah, Borton didn't botch the super kick for once. GG. We love you, Borton. Let's see a replay of that super kick, though, from close range, out of nowhere. Paul Devine going for a move, he didn't see it coming. And then Borton just plops into the pin. One, two, three. And the referee shaking the hand of Randy Borton. Randy Borton and the referee are best friends, it seems. Great victory for Borton, though, picking up some much-needed momentum. He hasn't been doing so well these past couple months, but heading into Over the Limit. Could be looking at our number one contender for the hardcore title at WrestleMania. It's time for our fourth matchup of the evening. Cole Savage, Mark Henry in his corner, going to take on Ringo Baxter. Mark Intel, his backup. Mark Intel saying earlier tonight that he and Ringo are not friends. He wants Ringo to understand that. They just have a mutual enemy in Cole Savage. Mark Intel saying that he knows he and Cyborg, that Savage, he as in Savage and Cyborg, are scared of Mark Intel. Mark Intel does not like Savage, does not like Cyborg as the general manager of Monday Night Raw. And last week, we saw Ringo Max and Martel actually team up to take on Savage and Christian, a losing effort. Here tonight, it is singles match. It is a singles match, one-on-one, Savage and Ringo Max. First time we're seeing these two go at it. Mano a mano, that is. Savage, as always, arriving in style here. Can't have it any other way. Yeah, Mark Dell's mad at Cole Savage because he called him Sheamus. Mark Henry couldn't fit in the car, though. He had to walk down the ramp by himself. Sherry's ringside. Martel and Mark Henry on the outside of the ring, though. That's a dangerous combination there, skulking in the outside area. Oh, there's Henry. He's clapping. He's inside of the barricade a little bit there. Actually, because there's been four other people in X-Gen. It's always been Omega's D and Sushi X. Now you got Troy Voodoo. There used to be Jeremy Blake, Duo Maxwell, Hayden, and remember anybody else? Only three people. Duo Maxwell, Hayden, Jeremy Blake. Who else has been in X-Gen? Nobody that I can remember. Only, there's only been six people in action in the total history of their stable. Fourth matchup of the inning, though. Up next, we'll see the hardcore champion Tim LaFave go toe-to-toe with Omega Z. Main event going to be Justin Sane, the world champion, teaming up with Troy Voodoo to take on Levi Martin and Hayden. From Rio Linda, California. The teamwork of Mark Tunnel Ringo match really on point last week. Grueling tag match between them and Cole Savage and Christian. Ringo, Mark Tunnel had the match won many times. Thanks to the teamwork of Christian and Cole Savage, though, they got the job done. Team LaFevre, Team LaFevre. Ringo Max, former member of the Naughty Guys, before he turned on his partner Fandango, adapted this new persona, the Austrian Death Machine, he titled himself. Didn't finish so well in the Cyborg Invitational. I'm sure he thinks just as Martel is. You know, they're not friends, they're not tag team partners, just working together to take on Cole Savage and his posse, his gang, Mark Henry and Christian. Gonna kick this match off. Referee rings the bell. Karanabo tie up. Ringo gets the early advantage. Has a little bit of a height advantage on the old timer here, the former two-time hardcore champion. Savage, though, turns that around. Waistlock takes it down to the canvas. Trying to force the air at Ringo Max here. Damn. Please chill, Cole Savage. Do not kill Ringo. We need him, kind of. Ringo counters into a waistlock of his own now. Ooh, slams him right into the canvas with a wrestling slam. Transitions to a side headlock. And now Ringo gonna get a little bit of payback here, wrenching on the neck of Savage. Everybody hates Cole Savage, Chrissy. Who knows why? They think that Cyborg gives him special treatment because they're friends. That's why they hate Cole Savage. Everybody on the roster is going to start a revolution against Savage, try to get him fired, sign a petition. Multiple atomic drops now by Savage. Going to cover for the pin already. Rope break, though. What Savage is thinking, maybe just trying to force Ringo to expend some energy. It's not lagging, Ruben. Maybe it's your stream, but I'm not getting any lag. Hip toss by Ringo Max now. Gonna drag Savage away from the ropes. Going for a rolling neck snap. Carter, get out of there. God, with this cat, dude. Just the presence of him in my room makes me furious. Pullback attack by Savage now. Ringo counters the kick to the midsection. Just ain't about that life. Pullback attack by Savage. Gonna try again. Another kick to the midsection. Now Ringo gonna go for pullback attack. Countered by Savage. Kick to the midsection. Let's keep this going. Come on. Oh, Savage gonna go for pullback attack. Kick to the midsection. No jawbreaker this time. Tip for tat there with the pullback attacks. Rest in peace. Pullback attacks on my arch nemesis. Who am I facing at WrestleMania this year? I'm facing pullback attacks, Twitch, the ropes. Oh, look at that, Savage. What a sell by the referee there. Savage with an elbow stamp took down the ref and Max Carter. Why do you keep coming in here and then leaving? Just stay out. Jesus. Stiff kick to the lower spine now by Carter. The referee should be a wrestler with that sell. Better than Randy Orton. What's this? Wheelbarrow Bulldog by Carter. Another man who has never held any form of championship gold in the CMB career. Max counters into a high angle dick slam. I think Cole might have been going for a signature there. Forearm to the jaw. What a super kick by Carter. Carter, I'm hitting like stupid cat now. By Max, I should say. Ringo Carter. Rex Max. Rex Max, actually, not a bad name. Rex Max. That's Rex Carter's porn name. Rest in peace. Counter now by Cole Savage into a Russian leg sweep.
He's got him hooked.
Front headlock. Ringo gets out of it, though, with a forearm to the jaw. Ringo with these forearms. Nice hip toss. Beautifully executed by a former two-time hardcore champion. Now gonna get a little bit of a head scissors here. Elbow. Rex the eyeball. Mark Hintzell and Mark Henry standing still. Oh, Mark Hintzell's going to clap a little bit here. Mark Henry doesn't like what he's seeing. Cole Savage not in the best positions right now. Is Ringo again going to mount him for some punches?
He's still not through.
Not done just yet. Going to go for another round? No. Lifting Savage to his feet. Teasing us. Making us think he has a signature, but no. Ooh, and what a Hurricane Rana by Max. Going back to his old Naughty Guys days. Locking a figure four head scissors. That might be a rope break, though. Should be a rope break, and it is. Just took the referee a while to realize it. Forcing the break, and now Ringo standing Cole Savage to his feet for Schrodinger's list. That impaler DDT, and that's got to be it. Covers for the pin. One, two, and only a two count, though. Ringo Max not happy about that. Cole Savage furious over it for his comeback now. Realizing he's in trouble, got to turn the tides, got to get the momentum in his favor. Go for his comeback. Victory roll by Ringo Max, though. One, two. Counter by Savage. One, two. Ooh, that was close to being a three right there. Cole Savage, how much we know how much he loves his roll-ups. Victory rolls his schoolboys. Pullback attack by Savage right into a European uppercut. Now a stiff kick to lower spine. Spine. Savage is all over Rex Carter right now. Realizing he doesn't want to get hit with that finisher, the Hangman's Noose, or the Banshee's Call. Especially the Hangman's Deuce, which I think he got caught in last week for a moment. Oh, wait a minute. He's not going to get caught with either. He's going to get a suicide dive as Ringo chucks him through the middle rope. Now Max stalking him, sizing him up, looking back, making sure it's all clear. Cole Savage doesn't know what's coming. Look out, old timer. Through the middle ropes. Rex Carter. Why am I thinking of fucking cat, dude, messing me up in my commentary. Ringo Max launching himself like a missile. Connecting directly to Savage. And now a belly to belly on the outside of the ring to follow it up. Where's Mark Henry? Henry, do your job. Jeez, man. Savage luckily countering that second maneuver. Planting Ringo Max face first. The outside of the ring. Referee to count of four right now. Spinning back elbow by the former hardcore champion.
And he's heading back inside the ring.
Count of six here. And look at this, Savage gonna taunt a little bit. Ringo Max not gonna be happy about that. Comes up from behind. I think Cole Savage thought he had a couple of minutes there. Nice combo by Carter. Carter, goddammit! Shut up, Dash. Ringo Max is not Carter. Ringo Max is Ringo Max. Rex Carter is Rex Carter. Carter is my stupid cat. Get it straight, Dash. Jeez. Please chill. Now pullback attack by Savage. Gets countered by Max into a nice belly to belly. Ringo pulling Savage to the middle of the ring with a front headlock, and now a neck breaker. Very back and forth between these two. I'm actually surprised. Max is handling himself very well against Savage in there. As is Savage handling Max very well. Cover for the pin. One, a two, only a two count. Rex Carter going for... See, I said Rex Carter that time, though, because Batman posted Rex Carter in caps in the chat. So that's Batman's fault that time. Carter. Oh my god, I did it again! What is going on, guys? I know I'm saying it wrong, but I can't stop. I don't know what's going on. I'm just because I'm saying Carter so much. I gotta just stop saying it. Oh, wait a minute. Cover for the pin. Oh! Ringo Max getting the pin. All these reverse DDTs tonight. Getting the job done. That's how Jackson Jordan beat Zach Cage earlier. And now Ringo Max defeating Cole Savage with the reverse DDT. Damn. Savage, jeez, man, falling to the reverse DDT. Maybe that's an insult from Ringo Max to a Christian, showing him how to hit a proper reverse DDT. I didn't even really see the finish because I was looking at the chat. I hope they replay. I think it was reverse DDT. I guess maybe the damage of the Schrodinger's list and the suicide out. That was the weirdest camera angles for the suicide dives. Literally looking at the ring apron. There he is. Taking Cole Savage out. Damn, what the sell by Savage, though. Okay, you can stop filming that. Yeah, it was a reverse DDT out of the corner there. Covers for the pin. That looks like that might have been a rope break from the angle we're looking at, but I don't know. Jeez, man. Cole Savage falling hard to Ringo Max here tonight. Here's as Mark Cattell congratulates his ally here. Kind of match now. Tit for tat. Savage and Christian getting a tag team victory last week. Ringo Max picking up a singles victory over Savage here tonight. Ringo going to celebrate this win while Mark Cattell checks out that ass. Thank God the match is over, though, so I can stop saying Carter. Rest in peace, my brain. Great win for Ringo, though. Now it is time for our co-main event of the evening. The hardcore champion, Tim LaFave, going to go toe-to-toe with Omega Z, Paul Devine, in his corner. We know the history between Paul Devine and Tim LaFave. Both men respect each other very highly. Can bet that Omega Z respects Tim LaFave. We'll find out right now. LaFave not kicking off his hardcore title reign the way he wanted to last week, taking a loss to Levi Marta. Great matchup. Very back and forth, but Marta did pick up the victory indeed. Only 24 hours after Tim won the championship at the Royal Rumble. Hopefully, he doesn't lose again here tonight to Omega Z. We saw Paul Devine take a loss to Randy Borton earlier tonight. Those two will be involved in the Gauntlet match at Over the Limit. Tim LaFave will be defending at Over the Limit, not in the Gauntlet match. Possibly he'll defend against Omega Z if the man from the future can get a victory over him here tonight. Ready, willing, and Gable. Or Savage. Yeah, ready, willing, and Savage. That's how it should be said. Oh my God. I think I'm dying, guys. I know I say it a lot, but I literally think I'm dying tonight. Don't worry about it, Chrissy. Mark Henry was hungry, okay? He was backstage getting some food. Don't worry about it. Paul Devine's a warrior. He's all right now. Tim LaFave making his way down the ramp into the ring. That hardcore championship in his hand. Raising it up high for everybody to see. Look at that smile on his face. Tim LaFave is happy to be the hardcore champion. Only 2 months into his CMB career. Won that championship by pinning Cole Savage in a fatal four-way at the Royal Rumble. Who's going to defend in 3 weeks' time at Over the Limit? And if he does defend against whoever his challenger will be, who will win that gauntlet match and meet Tim at WrestleMania? Respect. Excuse me. Tim LaFave's anti-abortion. That's his slogan. Good old Tim. Now here come the four-time tag team champions. Omega Z, a former Intercontinental champion, will be he in action here against Tim LaFave. As we saw earlier tonight, was defeated at the hands of Randy Borton. definitely going to be a great match, I feel, between these two. We saw the multiple encounters by or between Paul Devine and Tim LaFave, which culminated in a steel cage match some weeks back, which Paul Devine won finally after Tim LaFave beat him, was it, three times? Here we go, kick up this match off. Referee rings the bell. Starting off with a car and elbow tie-up. Mega Z takes the early advantage here, grabbing hold of Tim's arm, trying to tear it out of its socket. Takes around behind the back now. Report again, X-Gen.
Nobody wants to give an inch.
Oh, an elbow tie-up. Again, Omega Z takes the hold of Hardcore Champ's arm. Tim's had enough of it, though. Gonna show Omega Z how it's done. Look at Tim now. Tim's being a little bit aggressive here. Omega Z doesn't like that. Tip for tap, back and forth, targeting each other's arms as Devine stalks the outside area. Devine has now had four shots at the Hardcore Championship. Has not been able to bring home the gold, though. Well, over the limit. Finally, it's not even for the title, though. He'll just become number one contender again. Get a shot at WrestleMania. Well, WrestleMania be his night to finally become a Hardcore Champion. Irish Whip by Omega Z sends Tim off the ropes right into a power slam. Now, punch after punch after punch after punch to the chubby cheeks of Tim LaFave here. What did Omega Z just do? Did he chop Tim's throat? That MVP maneuver there. Goes for a clothesline. Drop toe hold by Tim. Great counter. Omega Z might have used the bottom turnbuckle there. And what a clothesline by Omega Z to fire back. Omega Z sizing Tim up for a neck breaker. Couldn't have felt too great. That was a nasty impact. And Omega Z right back to the punching. Referee's got to watch for those closed fists. Going for another punch. Omega Z, man, taking it to Tim right now. He respects LaFave. LaFave is a known brawler from New York. Can also be very athletic, though. He's going to hit that standing moonsault. Omega Z's just trying to, give Tim what he wants. Beating the crap out of him. Let's have a classic brawl here. I'm on the net. Raw, another power slam by Omega Z. Claps his hands. He thinks it's over. Only one count, though. Now another neckbreaker by Omega Z. Tim's got to do something already, guys. He is getting dominated by the man from the future here, taking a lot of damage to his head. And 24th punch. Luckily, Tim has his force fields activated. Pushes that punch back. A nice gut wrench suplex. Finally, mounts some offense and another pinpoint elbow drop to follow that up. Tim LaFave does not want to take another loss for the second straight week. His butterfly suplex. You know how much Tim loves his suplex. Butterfly suplexes, gut wrench suplexes, standard suplexes. Here's that standing moonsault now. Clapping his knees. And now Tim LaFave in the driver's seat. Realizes he's in trouble. Scoop slam. Very traditional is Tim LaFave's moveset. Dragging Omega Z away from the ropes there for another standing moonsault. Lifts him to his feet. Countered by Omega, though. Tim doesn't want that. Omega gonna close in, try to hit the Future Shock DDT, maybe go for the 24th punch again. Chest bump showing good sportsmanship. Pullback attack by the man from the future, belly to belly. Great counter by LaFave. Ass, titties, two asses, four titties. Ass, titties, titties, ass, and titties. Ooh, what a pinpoint elbow drop by Tim. Targeting the head of Omega now is Tim. Both these men just going after each other's heads. Trying to flicks and concussions, it looks like. And now a German suplex by Tim LaFave. Suplex City, bitch. That should be Tim's motto, let's be honest. Tries to make Omega humble. That's an automatic rope break, though. Good call by the referee. Uh-oh, what's this? Oh, Long Island Slam takes Omega down. Gonna cover for the pin. That should be a rope break, though. Or maybe it's not. Okay. Should have been, I think. Two count, though, luckily. And now Tim, where's he going? Exiting the ring. Where are you going, Tim? Tim, please respond. Where are you going? He just spazzed out, ran back in the ring. All right, then. That was weird. Irish Whip sends Tim out into the ring apron, punched the midsection, dragging Tim in through the ropes. Hangman's DDT. That was nasty. And Omega can get that 24th punch another go, perhaps. Yes, he is, but the force field's coming to play again. Omega's had enough. He's going for that Future Shock DDT. Fuck that 24th punch. Gonna go for the 1-2-3 as Omega Z. One, only a one count. Tim ain't about that life. Uh-oh, wait a minute, Omega Z. The timestamp! Oh, but he can't capitalize. Omega collapsing after he hits the timestamp, using the ropes to pull himself back up. Can he get the pin? Covers. One, two. No, Tim had too much time to recuperate. Able to kick out the very last millisecond there. Tim's going to be feeling the effects of that timestamp in the morning, though. And look at that, Omega Z maybe getting a little bit frustrated here. Upset that the timestamp didn't get the job done. He collapsed, though, after hitting it. Now Tim in the driver's seat yet again. Exiting the ring. What's Tim trying to do now? He's going to tear apart the announce table. Come on, Tim. You going to pay for that, huh? You going to pay for that, Tim? You going to compensate me? You know, I come out here. You know, I hire people to build those tables. They do their job. They do it well. Look, you're going to destroy that computer. You're going to destroy those headsets. Oh, my God, guys. Are we actually going to see someone get put through a table here? Oh, Timblefave's struggling, though. Timblefave's struggling to get him on the table. Yeah, he failed. He messed up there. Tim didn't know what was going on. Now another gut-wrench suplex. Tim going to give another go, maybe? Oh, yes, he is. Can he do it? Tim LaFave looking to send a message, perhaps, to... maybe not. Oh, yes, he is. Tim LaFave, guys. Tim LaFave has Omega on top of the announce table. What is this? The powerbomb? Sit-out powerbomb by LaFave. Puts Omega Z through the table. I think the ref's at 8, guys.
Boy, he is really tired.
8, he is at 8, guys. Tim can't get back to his feet, though. Tim's going to win by count out. 9. No, Tim breaks the count. Oh, no, wait. Oh, it was too late. Tim tried to break the count, but the referee called it, guys, and Tim LaFave wins by count out over Omega Z after putting him through the announce table with a powerbomb. Tim LaFave brings home the victory. He tried to break the count, but it was a little bit too late there. Referee called it, and it's over. Tim LaFave defeats Omega Z via countout. Tim LaFave, guys, getting the victory in kind of a shady way there. He tried to break it, though. He tried to break it, but he was too late, and Tim brings home the victory via countout, though. What a match, though. Tim LaFave trying to send a message to Divine, maybe who's ringside, everybody participating in the gauntlet, whoever his challenge will be, come over the limit, putting Omega Z through the table with a powerbomb to win this match. He tried to, I don't think the referee should have called that. I think he was out of the ring in time, but the referee's the official here. He called it, and Tim LaFave is your victor via countout. Tim LaFave, great matchup, kind of a shady victory. I'm sure Omega Z's not going to be happy about that one. Omega Z's not going to let that stand, I can assure you that much. I'm sure Paul Devine was like, what, Tim? You just went by a countout, my dude? Thought we respected each other. What's that all about? And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for our main event of the evening. World Heavyweight Champion Justin Singh going to shackle up with Troy Voodoo here to take on Levi Marta and Hayden. Levi Marta bursting into the COO Triple H's office last week, demanding a World Heavyweight Championship match against Santa Over the Limit. Getting in Hunter's face, you know, yelling at him like he was his superior or something. Talking down to the COO later on in the night. Triple H posted a video on CMB.com responding to Marta, saying he feels that Marta doesn't deserve a World Championship match, but Justin Singh does need a warm-up for WrestleMania, so at Over the Limit, in the main event, Justin Singh will go toe-to-toe with Levi Marta, and if Levi Marta can defeat Justin Singh, he will make the Triple H, he will make the triple threat, or the main event at WrestleMania, into a triple threat, I should say, for the World Heavyweight Championship. Of course, Hayden, we know, the 2017 Royal Rumble winner, no matter who the champion is, it's going to be Justin Singh. We just don't know if it's going to be a triple threat or a singles match now. Hayden returning at the Royal Rumble to win the whole dang thing. Took on Mark Henry last week, was attacked by Justin Singh before the match. Then Singh came back out, after the match was over and taunted Hayden. Of course, we know Troy Voodoo and Justice Hayden have some sort of weird alliance these past couple of weeks, attacking everybody. Zach Cage has just been getting relentlessly and mercilessly attacked by Troy Voodoo the past 3 weeks. He tried to attack him earlier tonight after Jordan beat him. Jordan wasn't having it, though. Fended Troy Voodoo off, saving Cage from another beatdown. The day Borton does a promo is the, I don't know, the day Brian isn't racist. I don't know where I was going with that. I don't know. Bless. Randy Borton will never do a promo, though. Rest in peace. Just insane. Been World Heavyweight Champion for 4 months now. Tane against the likes of Ryan Kent, Sunshine, Zach Payne, Troy Voodoo just recently in the Royal Rumble. Alliance or whatever the hell it is between Troy Voodoo and Justin Say, very odd to say the least. Will it last here tonight to take on Marta and Hayden? Question is, does Marta and Hayden get along? They're both nuts. Hayden says he's feeling better now. He says he went to therapy while he was gone and filming his new movie after American Justice got his hand up. Said he was going to therapy. He feels better now. He's not crazy anymore, but I don't know about that. I mean, he electric chaired a kid in the ring last week. Acted like he was his friend, celebrating with him, giving him an electric chair. He was wearing Justin Sane merch, tore it all apart. Sane did kill somebody, killed Troy Voodoo. RIP. Nobody loved you. Sorry.
And his tag team partner from Jacksonville, Florida, the future Troy Voodoo. Both teams look ready. I'm looking forward to this one.
King, how do you know if both teams look ready? Leo and Martin and Hayden aren't even out here yet. Here comes Troy Voodoo, the man who has a date with Jackson Jordan in 3 weeks over the limit for the United States Championship. Again, Troy Voodoo trying to attack Zach Cage for a third time earlier tonight. But Jackson Jordan defending Cage, clotheslining Voodoo over the top rope. Going to make Voodoo a little bit of damage here for this matchup. Not at 100%. That's not rifted, Chrissy. GG, though. Can't nobody out here touch this. I don't think I can listen to this song without singing along. Mention that you murdered your da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And I'll talk about that. Zach Payne probably did die again. He came in and said hi, and then he left. RIP.
And their opponents first. From the good old USA.
And their opponents first. From the good old USA, Bach, aka Levi Marta here. Former United States champion, tag team champion, hardcore champion, wants that world title now. If he can beat Justin Sane over the limit, he'll get his wish. It'll be granted. Main event of WrestleMania 3 will be added to a triple threat. Levi Marta probably not super happy. That's not going to be a one-on-one championship match against Sane himself, but you don't just barge into Triple H's office and demand whatever you like. It's not going to go down that way. Again, going to be interesting to see if Hayden and Marta can work together, knowing, you know, that if Marta wins against Sane at over the limit, then Hayden will have to, you know, get his Royal Rumble right, really, you know, thrown out the window and into a triple threat on a clean one-on-one match.
From London, England, Hollywood, play. Listen to that reaction.
This is the first time we're seeing this entrance, I think, because Justin State attacked Hayden last week. Hit him with this dank-ass new attire, in the words of Chrissy there. Looking ready for battle tonight. Looking ready to get his hands on Justin Sane. There is a poll on the website right now, guys. If you have not voted, make sure you do so. For the main event next week on Raw, you can vote for Troy Voodoo versus Hayden one-on-one, a six-man tag featuring Justin Sane, Voodoo, and Justin, or an American Justice teaming up to take on Jackson, Jordan, Levi, Marta, and Hayden. Or you can vote in American Justice versus Hayden in a no-holds-barred match. That's what's winning right now with 5 votes. The other 2 have 3 each. Sorry about that, guys. Here we go. Referee going to ring the bell as we kick off our main event. Episode 136 of CMB Dashing here. 3 weeks away from Over the Limit. 2 months away from the third annual WrestleMania, the Season 2 finale, before we head over to 2K16. And Justin Sane and Levi Marta going to kick things off here. Pushed back by Levi Marta. Tally with a shoulder jawbreaker. I don't know what you're asking. Are these your viewers' mods? What? Are these your viewers' mods? I don't know what that means. I don't know what you're asking exactly. Double tag here. In comes Voodoo. In comes Hayden. Voodoo not wasting any time trying to punch Hayden as he's stepping through the ropes. And Voodoo puts Hayden up on the top rope. This match started like 30 seconds ago. We're already going on the top rope for a maneuver. What is this? Tower of London! The stunner from the top rope there. That was nasty. Levi Marta having trouble staying on the ring apron. Uh-oh. Now Hayden going to get lost in the woods as Troy Voodoo jams his boot down Hayden's throat. The future unloads on Hayden here. Hayden not having it, though. Luthes press. A couple shots to the jaw. A couple more shots to the jaw. Hayden not playing around here. And just keeps on with the punches, does Hayden. That was the Tower of London. What are you talking about? Please chill. That was 100% definitely the Tower of London. What's this now? Enzo Lariat, vintage Hayden. Ooh, and now a knee to the jaw, knee to the side of the head, really. Hayden taking a second to back up there, and Voodoo is having some... He started off strong when he got tagged in against Hayden, but that's because he caught Hayden off guard right now. Hayden is taking it to the, still relatively new to CMB, not really, debuted around Night of Champions, former tag team champion, winner of the inaugural Cyborg Invitational, finished at 8-1, an astonishing 8-1, only one defeat in the tournament, unfortunately lost to Justin Sane at the Royal Rumble. What a spine buster by Hayden. That's what makes this alliance so weird between these two. Just a couple of weeks ago, Justin Sane and Voodoo went to war. Coleman ran into the rumble. And what a low blow. Punch right to the gonads. I hate him. Troy Voodoo can take that line down. Looking for his comeback. Goes for an enziguri, though. Going to cost himself here. Uh-oh. The catchphrase, though, by Kite. They're going to cover for the pin. And Justin Sane. Oh, the referee didn't know where he was for a second there, though. He was confused. Start counting the bell. Wait a minute. Hayden looking to finish things off quickly. Tiger Bomb inbound by the 2017 Royal Rumble winner. Going to count for the pin. Almost over right there already. Luckily, Justin Sane breaks it up just in time. And now Sane Irish whipping Hayden into the corner, trying to help Voodoo out a little bit here. Voodoo's just jobbing to Hayden right now, ladies and gentlemen. Kick to the back of the leg. Vintage Voodoo with these strikes to the chest. That final one going to go to the back of the head. And Sane's just begging for the tag right now. Sane realizing Voodoo's going to lose this match for them. And Voodoo slowly, desperately making his way over there to tag Sane now. Here we go. Preview of the main event of WrestleMania 3. Justin Sane and Hayden going at it. And Justin Sane right on top of Hayden. The get-go here. Knee to the side of the head. Spike single arm DDT. Justin Sane kicking things off between these two already last week. Attacking Hayden before he was before the match started against Mark Henry. Making his way down the ramp. Justin Sane came from behind, rammed him into the steel steps, rammed him into the ring apron, and pretty much fed him to Mark Henry. There's the need to win by Justin Zane. Hayden not going to sell it, though. Looking for his comeback. Caught with a spine buster. And this match is fast-paced as hell, man. All over the place. Marta's asking for that tag. Hayden ain't about that life, though. Hayden's got this. Damn. Justin Zane holding on to his balls. Zane with an Irish whip sends Hayden off the ropes. What is this? Catapult! Oh! Trouble in paradise, it looked like. Jesus. One, two. Marta breaking up the pins and also catching the referee with an elbow there. Please chill, Marta. Don't get your team disqualified. That catapult kick to the head, though. Never seen that before from Justin Zane. Tag into Levi and Marta now. Hayden's got to recuperate after that kick. Marta immediately gets caught by Zane, though. Puts him in the corner looking for a tag to Voodoo, perhaps. No, Marta gets out of it. Boots to the side of the head and a punch. Ooh, what a punch right to the balls.
Justice is getting served.
Justice is getting served. That's Hayden's signature name right there. Please chill, Michael Cole. Front head locked by Marta. Irish River gonna go for a pullback attack. Does not pay off though. Jawbreaker. What do you mean, where am I? I'm right here. Do you not hear me or something? Am I not live? Please chill. Ooh, and a dropkick right to the mouth. I believe Marta from a seated position. Covers from the pin as a world champion. Only one count though. Sweep kick by Zane does not pay off there. Uh oh, vintage Zane though. Gonna dance Marta around the ring for a little bit. I'm sure Marta's liking this. Marta's just as crazy as Zane. Troy Voodoo's in here with a bunch of fucking nuts people, dude. He's got a team with Justin Zane who's absolutely fucking bonkers. Levi Marta, he doesn't even know where he is half the time. He got Aiden, who claims to be okay now thanks to therapy, but he attacked the child last week. Troy Voodoo's probably like, Jesus, man. What has happened? Where am I in life right now? Nice Texas jab by Zane. Irish throws Marta into the corner. Put Marta up on the top rope. What is this? Wait a minute. Justin Zane been taking a couple training classes. The Brett Angel, perhaps, it seems, because pedigree from the top rope. Troy Voodoo's finisher, too. Marta completely no-sells him on that massive move from the top rope. And Marta's just like, nah, I don't feel like selling that. Looking for his comeback. Remind me, what's this? A German suplex. Wants to get that comeback off him. I don't know if he still has it. Apparently, he doesn't go for a brain chop. Shades of the great Khali, Levi Marta's mentor, as we all know.
The damage has definitely been done. Now it may just be a matter of time.
And now Justin Zane with the overdose, planting Levi Marta face first on the canvas, hits the leg. One, two, here comes Hayden to break up the pin, though. Didn't have faith in Levi Marta to kick on his own. And Zane, though, immediately gonna stalk Marta, looking for his finish, looking for the overkill, perhaps. Here it comes. Tosses him overhead, knee right to the back of the head, and that's gotta be it. Shoots the half, referee count it. One, two, no, Troy was a little bit late trying to stop Hayden there, it's gonna cost his team. That would have been it. Marta almost falling to Justin Zane, wouldn't be great for him heading into over the limit where he will go one on one with the world champion. Now a knee right to the jaw. The main event of Monday Night Raw continues, episode 136. Next episode will be on Wednesday. Go Home Show on Friday. We'll have Over the Limit, our last pit stop for WrestleMania on Saturday. And then WrestleMania itself, just 2 weeks away, will be that following Sunday, guys. Cannot wait. Justin Zane with a nice little camel clutch there. Not looking for this mission, just trying to wear Marta down a little bit. And now here comes another overdose. Hooks the leg, yeah, again. Marta's just getting chomped on right now by Justin Zane, guys. Troy Voodoo fails with that enziguri, completely misses. And now Zane immediately stalking Marta again. Gonna take another overkill. Poor Marta, dude, he's getting shit kicked right now, dude. And there it is, the overkill by Justin Zane. Hooks the leg, referee, wake up, come on. One, two, but Troy Voodoo's too slow, man. He can't stop Hayden. Hayden's got half the team on his back right now. Justin Zane. How many more sigs and fins can he hit on Marta before Marta just dies? Rest in peace. You tried. Levi finally with a little bit of defense. He's got to make the tag to Hayden, man. Zane with a flashback off the rebound. Now Zane gonna tag in Voodoo, saying, here, I'm beating the shit out of this guy. Attacking Troy. Wait a minute, hot tag. Marta getting there just in time. Here comes Hayden, fired up. Takes Voodoo off his feet. Goodbye, Justin Zane. Have a nice trip. See you next fall. And can Hayden capitalize here? What's he going for? Just tossing Troy Voodoo overhead like he's a sack of dirty laundry. They're going to go for the pin. That'll be a rope break, though. It should be, and it is. What's Justin Zane doing? Zane, not the legal man. Just one Texas jab to Hayden. Going to try to allow Troy Voodoo to get back to his feet in time, and it does. Great teamwork by Voodoo and Zane. Hayden nice and fresh, though. Marta's out of it, guys. This match is really on Hayden's shoulders now. Pretty much a handicap. And Zuleri yet again by the 2017 Royal Rumble winner. Covers for the pin. Just Hayden. Immediate breakup by Justin Zane, though. Not even a one count for Blade. And what's Hayden looking for now? Looking for another catchphrase. That's the second one Voodoo has eaten tonight. Covers from the pin. Here comes Zane yet again, having to make a save. Forearm to the jaw by Troy Voodoo. Goes for a clothesline. Countered by Blade, though. Punches him back. Now Voodoo looking to tag in. Zane here. Going for a little bit of a tag team maneuver. Irish whip. Voodoo going to catch him on the rebound with a drop toe hold. Zane with an elbow to the upper back there. Hayden's arm might have been broken. That looked nasty. Uh-oh, wait a minute. An overdose for Hayden now. Tip for tat. Justin Zane all about equal opportunity. Marta almost not able to pick up the pin again. Hits the referee. Please chill, Marta. Get your team DQ'd, dude. Insane. Sizing Hayden up to eat an overkill. Here it comes, dude. Justin Zane is on fire tonight. He is just taking it to both his possible number one contenders at WrestleMania. Here comes Marta, going to do his part, saving Hayden, not even a one count. Hayden has a finisher too, remember, though. Gets backed up into the corner. Hayden's dead right now, guys. Oh, nice rebound, German suplex out of the corner. Justin Zane just having his way with both Hayden and Marta here in the main event of Monday Night Raw. Ooh, what an uppercut, traditional American uppercut there. And Hayden, we're going to finish this match off. Don't get up, Zane. Tiger Bomb by the 2017 Royal Rumble winner. One, two, but Zane not damaged enough. Hayden's got to be thinking, what the hell? Oh, tagging in Marta now. I don't know how much of a good idea that is. Levi is seriously damaged. Get pinned off of any move. Let's see a reverse DDT, please. Marta immediately with a Lutez press and some punches. Marta now taking a couple steps back for that pinpoint knee drop. Zane looking for his comeback now. He's pissed off. Counter into a Russian leg sweep. Front headlock now. Zane's going to wear his own comeback down. So smart. Knee right to the face. Ooh, the audio right there. What was that? The spirit of Scott Norrie trying to contact us. Double forearms, clothesline into the face buster, guys. And that could, yeah, anything could be it at this point for Marta. Let's be honest. Hayden gonna be able to break that up, though. Not even a one count. Lutez pressed by Marta to retaliate. Some heavy shots in the jaw. Ooh, and he busts Zane open. I don't know how Justin Zane got busted open before Levi Marta, but okay. And now Marta going for his pump handle neck breaker. Looking to finish this match off. One, two. Good guy referee waits for Voodoo to get in the ring though before he starts the count. GG. Well, damn, that's a nasty cut. Wait a minute. Jumping cutter out of nowhere. All right. That busts Marta open finally. Hayden breaks it up though. I haven't seen Justin Zane hit the cutter in a while. Now both men are bleeding. Nasty gashes on their forehead. Blackout by Justin Zane. Middle kick. Good night, Levi Marta. Texas jab by Zane. Shoulder jawbreaker. Quite the main event between these four. It's been all, pretty much been all Justin Zane taking on Levi Marta and Hayden. Troy Wood, every time he gets in the ring, gets his ass kicked. So Justin Sage just like, chill, bro. All right, I got this. You all right, fam? Levi Marta targeting that cut on Sage's forehead. Again, covers for the pin. One, two. I got hiccups. Please chill. This is the main event of Monday Night Raw. So you're a little bit late there, Childish Gent. But wait a minute. Justin Sage about to greet the most deadly move in the history of CMB, the snake bite. Covers, doesn't wait for the animation to be able to recover. Luckily, Buddha breaks it up. Count of one there. From behind, Hayden, not the legal man. Justin Sane fighting back. Will that allow Marta to capitalize the distraction, though? Come on, Marta. Ooh, what a punch. And another punch. Now Dragon Sane in the middle of the ring. Couple punches to the ribs, the face, the back. Just going to plop into the pin. Voodoo breaks up the pin there, though. Now a kick right to the kidneys, the ribs there. Someone do some squats, please. Someone do squats. We need some exercising right now in this match. Uh-oh, another overdose could get the job done. Nah, Hayden's on point with it. That was pretty close, though. 2.99999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999 already. There it is, the overkill for the third time to Levi Marta. Good guy referee. Keeps forgetting where he is. Marta is fucking pretty much half dead right now at this point, guys. I don't know how he's standing. Wait a minute, still has enough left in him though to hit another pump handle neck breaker somehow. Jesus. That should be a rope break anyhow. Please chill, Voodoo. Oh, leg drop bulldog out of nowhere. Gonna cover for the pin. Here comes good guy Hayden to save the day, though. God, I hate referees, dude. Fuck me. The referee calling the tag. The only good thing he's done. Oh, Jesus. Oh, my God. That could be it. One, two, three. What a finish. Marta clotheslining both Voodoo and Justin Sane. Like a second after Sane attacked to Voodoo. And he gets the pin. What? That was hilarious. What a finish, though. Oh, that was beautiful. Levi Marta pinning Troy Voodoo off a clothesline. That knocked down Sane, too. Poor Sane was just trying to get out of the ring. Damn, what a clothesline by Levi Marta. Let's get that replay. Look at this. It knocks down both Sane and Troy Voodoo. Covers Voodoo. And gets the three count. Poor Voodoo, dude. On that jobber. That jobber I see here tonight. Jesus. Sane was trying to protect him all match, and then the moment he tags him in, he gets pinned in like a second. GG, no re. What a victory for Marta and Hayden, though. Marta, bloody bruise and all, taking three overkills in the hands of Justin Sane. Not a great preview of things to come for him at Over the Limit. But they're going to be celebrating tonight. Elimination Chamber in 3 weeks. No, Over the Limit. Please chill, universe. We don't have any news alerts. Rest in peace. Please load game. Jesus Christ. Oh, no losers, all right. Main event. All right, well, the singles match. To appease Voodoo and Dynamic once and for all, we're going to see it, guys. Troy Voodoo going to go toe-to-toe with Ryan Kent, Zach Cage, and his friend, his tag team partner's corner there, hoping Kent can dish some damage out to Voodoo. Get some revenge for all the attacks Voodoo has initiated on Zach Cage these past couple of weeks. Please chill, fly on my screen. Go away, fly. Fly, go away. Get off my TV. Whew. Get out of here. All right, Voodoo versus Cat with Cage. Oh, and then Levi Marta versus Voodoo. And then Mark Henry versus Borton. Rest in peace, Borton. Jesus. Go away. Fly. I will end your insignificant life, you piece of shit. Stupid fly. The moment I actually need the cat in here to get the fly off my screen is the moment he's not. And we'll see Paul Anderson in action. He could take on... Who wasn't on Raw? Let's see. He took on Kendall Wolf. We haven't seen Kendall Wolf in a while. Let's put him in action. Let's get him. See if he can get himself some momentum heading into that gauntlet match at Over the Limit. I am racist to flies. I don't like flies. I don't like no flies in my house. We're not welcome around these parts. You hear? Don't worry about why my cat eats flies. Don't worry about that. And then in the main event, let's have... Let's see, who wasn't on Raw? Chad Vegas, but I don't know about him. Get the American Justice. Sunshine still missing. Rest in peace. We got Zach Payne. Who can Zach Payne take on? Zach Payne with Jake Watts in his corner. He can fight someone. Fly! Jesus. Who should Zach Payne fight? Who should Payne fight? Come on. Let's see. I'm getting so irritated right now. I can't wait to kill this thing. Yeah, not Tyrant. Please chill. I'm thinking either maybe Tim or maybe Borton. I don't know. Borton already got a victory for himself this week, though. Well, let's see. Randy Bourne to Paul Devine. Who would you like him to see? Because we already see Kendall Wolf in action earlier tonight. He's announced for the gauntlet match. So, Zach Payne versus either Paul Devine or Randy Bourne. You guys vote right now. I'll give you like 10 seconds. Randy Bourne or Paul Devine. Please respond. Sorry if you heard that scratching. My head's itchy as fuck. 10 more seconds. We got 2 votes for Devine. 3 votes for Devine. 4 votes for Devine. All right, it's Devine. Rest in peace, Borton. Oh, my God. Fly. You don't know how irritating this is for me right now. All right, ladies and gentlemen, episode 136 of Community Universe Mode live here tonight on Main Event, just 3 weeks away from Over the Limit. Got a jam-packed show here of singles action. Kicking things off with Troy Voodoo going toe-to-toe with Ryan Kent. Zach Cage, of course, the tag team partner of Ryan Kent. We know these past couple weeks, Troy Voodoo just had it out for Cage, attacking him before his match with Jackson Jordan, attacking him last week on Main Event, then attacking him again earlier this week on Raw. Luckily, Jackson Jordan was there to make the save, surprisingly. Jackson Jordan will defend his U.S. title against Troy Voodoo at Over the Limit, but Jackson with that face turn to save poor Zach Cage, and now hopefully Cage praying that Kent can dish out some revenge for him here tonight over the inaugural Cyborg Invitational winner. Because it's my life and I'll live it how I see fit, Chrissy. Making moves, I think in 2K16 I should just turn off music for everybody and I'll sing the entrances they want. I think that's what we should do. I think I'm a beautiful singer. Please chill. Be auditioning for American Idol next season. Be singing this song. Nobody out here touches, all the players wanna be us, all the ladies wanna love us. Better than Meek Mill, confirmed. Thank you. Bless. I don't know, maybe Idol is canceled. I don't watch it, so I don't know. Hello, Falcon Knee. Katie Gary? Katie Gary, dude. Jesus, come on, Tim. Please say a name properly for once. Katie Gary. Oh God, we're gonna miss you in 2K16, Justin Roberts. What are we gonna do without you? Oh, fucking Jesus Christ. Hello, Beast Mode. Wait a minute, is that you, Beast? Is that the Beast? I don't think that's the Beast, but if it is, I think that is Beast. Beast, is that you? Please respond. We miss you, Beast. Oops. Double tapped that at my accident there. Here we go. Referee ringing the bells. We kick off this first matchup on Main Event. The Beast from the East. Oh, rest in peace, Beast. You're out there somewhere. We love you. Troy Voodoo and Ryan Kent going to kick off the show here. Zach Cage skulking the outside. Keeping his eye on old Troy Voodoo there. Why does Voodoo have it out? Zach Cage, man. We saw Voodoo attack Cage while Justin Sane attacked Ryan Kent last week. Cage and Kent were taking on X-Gen, really cost them the matchup against Paul Devine and Omega Z. Before that, we saw Troy earlier that week. We saw Voodoo attack Cage on Raw to take his place against Jackson Jordan. And then earlier this week, we saw Troy Voodoo attack Cage again after his match with Jackson. But Jordan wasn't having it. Fired back, clotheslining Voodoo out of the ring, saving that Cage. Voodoo here locking in a beast fight on Ryan Kent. Ryan Kent about to tap? Yeah, that locked in for a while. Thought Kent was actually going to tap right there. Jesus. Oh, damn, dude. What a spinning back fist. Just put Voodoo right on his ass. Rest in peace, dude. That was brutal. What is this now? Mishinoku driver by Kent. Stop Troy Voodoo dead in his tracks. Voodoo suffering a loss alongside Justin Sane earlier this week in the tag match against Levi Martin and Hayden. Now Voodoo. And for that butterfly DDT vintage view. Vintage half the CMB roster, though. He's putting those educated feet to good use. Zach Cage just gingerly walking across the bottom of our screens. Wait a minute, Troy Voodoo already with a SIG. Boot to the side of the head, and down goes Kent. Flips him over, covers. One, two. Oh my god, that was close right there. Ryan Kent is in serious trouble right now. Voodoo almost has a beat.
I don't know what more you want to do to another man.
And now Kent going to show Voodoo how to hit a proper middle kick. And another middle kick just to make sure he saw it. Now Kent raising Troy to his feet. What's he looking for here? Goes for a grapple. Countered by Voodoo though, needing the midsection. And Voodoo kicks to the midsection. Hooks the arms. The pedigree! Flips him over, shoots the half. One, two. Oh, Ryan Kent somehow able to power out the very last millisecond there. Ryan Kent somehow kicking out of the pedigree. He's in trouble right now, though. Voodoo's all over him. Ryan Kent does not want to let down Zach Cage. Backbreaker, neckbreaker combo now by the former undisputed world champion. Money in the Bank holder, NXT champion, hardcore champion. A couple stomps down into the chest now. From behind. Nice blue thunderbomb. Now Kent looking to fire back. Bring Voodoo to his feet, kick to the midsection. That single knee face breaker. Good night, Troy Voodoo. Gonna cover. One, two. Only a two count Voodoo. Able to get out of that one there. Voodoo's got a date with Jackson Jordan through his time over the limit. United States Championship up for grabs. Nice lariat takedown. Coming up from behind. The winner of the inaugural Cyber Invitational. Beautiful reverse DDT. Looks like Kent might have been going for a super kick there. Troy Voodoo just ain't about that life. Kent flings him back. Listen to his feet now. Drop kick. Voodoo didn't see that coming. Goes for a stomp. Voodoo rolls out of the way, though. Knives to Zaguri to retaliate. Trying to get himself back in this matchup. Now it's Voodoo who's in trouble. That Cage telling the fans to shut up. That's not very face-like, Cage. Oh, wait a minute, though. Troy Voodoo coming back with another kick to the side of the head. That busts Kent open. Waiting for the pin. Ryan Kent had to sell that kick. One, two. Only a two count, though. What a way to kick off main event. These two going at each other. They both got finishing now. Wait a minute. The power slam. What would be a Ryan Kent match without this? We need to bring Busta down to the knee as well. Rope break. Troy Voodoo has the ring awareness to extend his arm there and hit the bottom rope. Ooh, jab to the kidneys. Look like dropkick to follow it up. Middle kick. Ryan Kent bleeding badly from a cut on his forehead there. Need a couple stitches. Front headlock on Voodoo now. Irish whistles to the corner. Coming up from behind. What's Kent looking for here? Back elbow by Voodoo. Great counter. Looks like he was going for another Enziguri. Kent wasn't having that though. Mishinoku driver instead. Grabs one of Troy's legs here. Looking to finish this match off. And he does! Three count for Ryan Kent. Voodoo's down. day. That Michinoku driver. Enough to put old Voodoo down for the count here. I mean, to be fair, he did take a single-knee face breaker. But damn, Voodoo falls down to the Michinoku driver. Jeez. What a victory for Ryan Guy. Put all matches on normal, Chrissy. Please chill. Great win for Ryan Guy. I'm sure Zach Cage is happy about this one. She's laughing on the outside of the ring. Look at that Michinoku driver. Beautifully executed by Kent. Hooks that leg quickly to get the three count. Look at that. Troy Voodoo's asleep, guys. His eyes are closed. He's out. God damn. I never put matches on slow. I only put important matches on slow. Simmer down, Chrissy. You don't know what you're talking about. What a win for Ryan Kent. Zach Cage celebrating with his tag team partner here. Bloody bruised it all. Still to come here tonight, our main event is going to be Zach Payne taking on Paul Devine, two of the participants in the Gauntlet match at Over the Limit. Right now, before we get there, Paul Anderson, who returned to the Royal Rumble, who beat Randy Orton last week on main event, going to be taking on Kendall Wolf, another participant in the Gauntlet match. I never put all the matches on slow, because I don't know what you're thinking. The show would literally be longer than it is. That show would be too long. Matches would be too long. Only important matches are on slow, or matches I think deserve to be on slow. Please chill. Because he doesn't know what he's talking about. I think that fly went down my goddamn throat now. Dirty flies. Please chill, Voodoo. It's a Michinoku driver, not a scoop slam. Get it right. And he hit you with a single knee face breaker. All right. Here comes Paul Anderson, former World Heavyweight Champion. Only the second ever world champion in CMB history. Tag team champ, two-time tag team champion. Last time we saw him before the Rumble was at Survivor Series, a couple months off. Entered at number, I don't know, 26 maybe, 25, 26. The Rumble didn't last very long before getting tossed out, but great showing against Orton last week. We haven't seen Kendall Wolf since the Rumble. He participated in the Rumble. I think he came out number 4. Lasted a little while before getting tossed out. Been a while since we've seen him in singles action or any type of other match, though. Since a couple of weeks off. It's a first time matchup happening here, I'm pretty sure.
Approaching the ring from Detroit, Michigan, Kendall Wolf.
Kendall Wolf been involved in these weird promos with Bizarre Marta and Phil Cypher the past couple of weeks, though. They're talking about a war that happened in another dimension, people killed, who knows what the fuck is going on, who knows what they're talking about. Levi Marta and Phil Cypher seem to want to destroy Kendall Wolf or something, though. Something's going on there. We know the history of Kendall Wolf and Levi Marta, former members of Splendor under Sunshine. Battled over the United States title early on in the year. Payback, SummerSlam and the like. Kendall Wolf, a former two-time United States champion. Tim's very upset. Here we go. Referee going to ring the bell as Paul Anderson and Kendall Wolf tie up here in the second matchup of the evening. Main event. Paul Anderson going to take the early advantage, slamming Kendall Wolf down to the canvas. Side headlock now. WrestleMania just 2 months away, guys. Season 2 finale. Where we head on over to 2K16. Brand new show, brand new titles. Season 3 begins. Cannot wait. Who will carry over? See some faces turn, even older faces than you expect. It'll be quite the season premiere. Cannot wait. It's going to be good. It's going to be fun times. We still got a while to go before we get there, though. Over the limit, just 3 weeks away. What a punch to the jaw there. Paul Anderson by Kendall Wolf. We already got one match set for WrestleMania in 2 months. Justin Zane defending his world title against the 2017 Royal Rumble winner Hayden. But that could change if Levi Marta is able to defeat Justin Zane over the limit to become a triple threat. Marta added to the mix. I'm definitely going to be modding some new people after this show. Rest in peace. Is he digging back some old episodes there? I don't think that was a throwaway, Chrissy. They were both participating in the Money in the Bank ladder match. And I thought it would be a good match. I put it on slow. I thought it deserved it. Why are you thanking me, Borden? What? Are you thanking me for being your light in life? You're welcome. That's the arm bar there by Kendall Wolf. I think he just rolled back, saw a little bit of his dick is hanging out of his pants. I think that was a little bit weird there. I don't know what was going on. Nice enziguri. Takes Kendall down. Covers for the pin to Paul Anderson. Only a two count, though. What? No, Tim. It's on Saturday. We've still got two more Raws. Over the Limit is on Saturday. Next episode of Raw will be Wednesday. Go Home Show on Friday. And then WrestleMania will be the next Sunday. Another enziguri by Paul Anderson and Kendall Wolf. Gonna be feeling that in the morning. Might take a couple Advil after this matchup. Nice spine buster. Vintage Anderson hooks the legs to the pin. Gets a two count. And now Kendall Wolf's got to be very weary of that super kick of Paul Anderson's that can come out of thin air. Randy Borton ate it last week. Took him down for now. That's the king of main event, Kendall Wolf. Got to be on his toes. Oh, goes for it right there. Luckily, Kendall Wolf saw it coming. European uppercut counter. Almost ate that boot. Jawbreaker by Kendall Wolf. Now staggers Paul Anderson back. Goes for a Texas jab, but misses. It went through Anderson's head. Rest in peace. Now Anderson's got Kendall Wolf in the corner here. Oh, Kendall blasting out, though, with a slobber knocker. Elbow to Kendall Wolf's thigh there. Drags him to the middle of the ring. Kicks to the midsection. DDT plants him right into the mat. Covers for the pin. Will that be it? One. Two, only a two count, barely a two count for Paul Anderson. Oh, goes for the super kick. Paul not playing around. But wait a minute, now Wolf gonna go for his reverse DDT countered by Anderson. Counter after counter after counter here.
Uh-oh, it might be time to run.
Kendall Wolf not looking for his comeback. I don't even know who has a finisher now. I'm pretty sure it's Paul Anderson. I might have a signature instead, though. Nice count off the suplex into a neck breaker. Kendall trying to get that comeback off. There's the forearm. Tip up. Reverse atomic drop. Can he finish it off the scoop slam? Yes, he can. Not even going to go for a... Oh, no. He's lifting him up. Looking for the signature. Going for Too Hot in the Kitchen or something like that. I don't even know what the full name is. Weird name. Too Hot in the Kitchen by Kendall Wolf. That fireman's carry slam almost gets him a win there. Paul Anderson struggling to get back to his feet. What's this now? Kendall Wolf Going for the lift up reverse DDT. That could be it. Hooks the leg. What? That was a rope break. What was that sound? Jeez. Rope break for Paul Anderson. Got very lucky. Did the former world champion there. Knee to the midsection by Anderson. And now Paul with the super kick out of thin air. Middle of the ring. Shoots the half. One, two, three. And that's it as Paul Anderson brings home the victory. Got lucky with that rope break. Kendall, I think, would have finished him off with the lift up reverse DDT. But Anderson got lucky. Stood right up. Bam! Super kick to finish this thing off. Great matchup between these two. As Anderson continues his winning streak since coming back to CMB. Beating Borton last week, now Kendall here tonight. Two of the participants in the gauntlet match at Over the Limit. Anderson may very well earn himself a spot in that number one contenders match. Definitely looks like Kendall has a tear in his pants.
Here is your winner, Paul Anderson. He gets a quick victory here tonight.
Now it is time for our main event, the final matchup here on episode 136 of Commuter Universe Mode. Zach Payne alongside Jake Watson, as always, going to take on Paul Devine, of course, flanked by Omega Z. Both these men participating in the gauntlet match at Over the Limit. We saw Paul Devine take a loss to Randy Borton on Raw. Zach Payne had the night off. He's nice and fresh here. That was a number one contenders match, though, Chrissy. So, yes, that did deserve to be on Slow. Keep going back, though. It's cold in here, man. Woo! We all know the history between Zach Payne and X-Gen. Zach Payne and Big Show against X-Gen, of course. Went back and forth exchanging the tag team titles between one another. The last couple of months of 2015. Zach Payne and Big Show won their championships from X-Gen, went on to become the longest reigning tag team champion until hashtag trending worldwide came around. Now they hold that right. Please chill. Troy Buda actually is the highest ranked on the roster. He has the highest overall. I'm pretty sure he's 98. So please chill, Voodoo. He's just hit a rough patch, alright? He went 8-1 in the Cyber Invitational, so now he has to pay his dues. He has to take a couple losses over the next month. You know what I'm saying? You gotta pay your dues here in CMB. Zach Payne, flanked by his protege, Jake Watson. If I nerfed his stats, he wouldn't be at 98. Please chill. Chris Chet's the real number one jobber. I'm sorry, bless. How do you know Borton has 86 overall? I don't even know what Borton's overall is. That fly is still just chilling on my TV. I'm about to give it a what for. Please get it right, Voodoo. I said 98. Because Voodoo's important, Borton. I pay attention to his overall, not Borton's. I have Troy Vudu's overall written all over my walls. I say it to myself before I go to sleep at night. Troy Vudu, overall of 98. Here we go, main event, Zach Payne. Going to square off against Paul Devine. Two of the participants in the number one contenders gauntlet match at Over the Limit. Shot at the hardcore title come WrestleMania. Zach Payne, a former hardcore champion in his own right. Paul Devine chasing that title for nearly 6 months now. Has had four chances at it. Can't seem to get the job done. Tim LaFave, the current hardcore champion, actually defeated that man ringside on Mega Z earlier this week on Monday Night Raw by putting him through a table and winning by countout. Zach Payne could get out of that into a waist lock now. Zach Payne also the first ever United States champion. Tag team champion, as I said earlier. Paul Devine, though, four-time tag team champion alongside Omega Z. Has yet to hold singles gold, though, while Omega Z became an intercontinental champion early on in his career. Won it inside the Armageddon Hell in a Cell at Bad Blood. Good times. The OG Omega Z. Nice Pele kick by Payne. I don't think it really connected, though. Looked like he hit it. Kind of botched it a little bit there, Zach. Vintage Payne going to go for the snapmare. Rebounds off the ropes, and what a boot right to the face. Because that was, like, 6 days ago, seriously, 5 days ago. Omega Z is stronger than Mark Henry. Omega Z is the world's strongest man. Spike single arm DDT by Payne now. Devine, but it's broken his neck there. That angle, if we just saw that, look nasty T-bone suplex.
He's putting those educated feet to good use.
Putting those educated feet to good use. SummerSlam's my favorite pay-per-view. Divas in bikinis. Vintage Zach Payne combo. Twisting neckbreaker right into the triangle hold. Hyperextending the arm. Legs wrapped around the throat. Let's go, though. Oh, jumping cutter already by Zach Payne. Hooks the leg. One, two, only a two count, though. That came out of nowhere, as per usual with the RKO and ZKO, the jumping cutter, Vintage Payne. Vine's got to be on his toes now. Watch out for the knee trembler. What a slap. Uh-oh, kill confirmed. Nowhere near the ropes for Devine. The Asian sensation is serious trouble here. Payne's got that sleeper hold locked in tight. Oh, but Devine refuses. Zach Payne has to let go. Gonna go for the pin though. Devine might be out of it. One, two. No, only a two count. Devine fights out. Main event here. Paul Devine going toe to toe with Zach Payne. Already in trouble as the Asian sensation. Got locked in that kill confirmed. Luckily, he's able to last long enough. Payne letting go. Standing shooting star. Beautifully executed by the one and only Paul Devine. Single arm back body drop now. Jake Watson watching his mentor. Front row seat there. Omega Z there. Blending in with the turnbuckle or the apron almost. Running forearm smash. Devine counters that though. Uh-oh, now Paul Devine with the Mugen flip. Plants Zach Payne top of his head right into the mat. Flips him over. Covers. One, only a one count though. Zach Payne going to the Randy Orton School of Selling. Where is Payne going? Climbing to the top rope. Zach Payne rarely goes to the top, ladies and gentlemen. What's he looking for here? Oh, Devine gets back to his feet. Zach Payne, the dirty spot monkey. Going for a blue thunder bomb. Only gets a two count there. Very close though. You know how much Zach Payne loves his blue thunder bombs. Enziguri. Countered by Paul Devine. Nice chest bump now. Snapmare and another big move for the third time in this match. Zach going to take to the air again. Springboard knee. He gets it. Not the full effect, but lands on his back, it looked like. And now Zach going for another jumping cutter. This could be it, guys. Big trouble for Paul Devine. One, two, three, and Zach Payne gets the victory off his second jumping cutter. Zach Penn, a little streak of his own, defeating Troy Voodoo last week on Main Event. Hopefully he doesn't get blasted in the face by Justice with the title during his celebration. Great victory for Payne, though. Two jumping cutters and a kill confirms what it took to put Paul Devine down for the count. Devine hasn't had such a great week. Losing to Borton on Raw, now Zach Payne. Here's the second jumping cutter. Just too much for Paul Devine to take here. Jake Watson cheering on his mentor. And Zach Payne picks up the three count. And no cutscenes here on Main Event. I think this is the first time we've seen that. We usually always get cutscenes on Main Event. Justin Sane's not in the arena tonight, so he can't attack anybody. Jumping cutter. As always, thank you guys for joining me for Community Universe 1 episode 136. Next episode will be on Wednesday, then Friday will be the go home show, Over the Limit on Saturday. WrestleMania just 2 weeks away, the Sunday that follows. So if you like what you saw, you're new to the show, make sure you follow me. I stream every Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Wednesday. All the past episodes are on my YouTube channel, which is linked on my Twitch page, all past 135 episodes. Feel free to go over there and check them out. And the website for the show is communityuniverse.foremotion.com if you want to join up. The show is on Xbox One. You got to make your own call. But feel you're more than welcome to come on over and check out the site if you want to. So I will see you guys on Wednesday for episode 137.